President Trump's legal challenges to his election loss are not going well. The president wants to launch more lawsuits, and for that, he has put his chief conspiracy theorist in charge. CNN's Drew Griffin joins us now with more. How's this going to work?
Allison, many see that chief conspiracist ruining his own reputation. But what Giuliani and his client Donald Trump are doing beyond reputation ruining, Allison, has the potential for long-lasting damage to the country.
It would be laughable if this wasn't so dangerous.
You start doing ballots like this.
Rudy Giuliani on Fox Sunday spinning his latest false conspiracy theory about an American voting machine company, a bizarre take involving George Soros, votes being counted in Spain, and dead strongman Hugo Chavez.
A company that has close ties with Venezuela and therefore China.
False. Truth, facts, they don't seem to matter to Giuliani, who's tweeting, posting on YouTube, showing up on far right-wing shows, spouting wildly false allegations, even from the parking lot of a landscaping company next to an adult bookstore.
Wow, what a beautiful day.
His argument in Philadelphia that vote counters were purposely hiding ballots from Trump's poll watchers.
Because many, many of them were fraudulent.
Not true. This is the man President Trump has just put in charge of his legal challenges to Joe Biden's presidential win. A stack of lawsuits has already been thrown out or dropped, including 9 in one day.
All of the cases are falling apart. The way he's going about continuing to file cases with no basis in court just makes Donald Trump a loser more times.
In a Pennsylvania lawsuit, a judge asked Trump's attorney, "Are you claiming that there is any fraud in connection with these disputed ballots?" The Trump attorney admitted, "No." Yet along with other Trump cronies, Giuliani keeps feeding the world his debunked conspiracy theories.
In each state, there were ineligible ballots that overwhelmed the margin of victory.
No, Mr. Giuliani, there weren't. The United States Department of Homeland Security issued this joint statement from its Elections Infrastructure Committee stating there is no evidence that any voting system deleted or lost votes, changed votes, or was in any way compromised.
Rudy Giuliani is undermining confidence in the American election system and therefore undermining our national security.
It's a far cry from the man who was dubbed mayor of the world in the wake of 9/11. Ever since Giuliani became a vocal supporter of the president's 2016 presidential bid, he's been Trump's chief conspiracist, even traveling to Ukraine to try to dig up dirt on Hunter Biden. Intelligence officials told the White House Giuliani was the target of a Russian influence operation in 2019, according to the Washington Post.
It is very dangerous and it's extremely alarming.
Former federal prosecutor Ken McCallion, who specializes in Russian organized crime and once worked with Giuliani, believes Giuliani may be unwittingly doing the Russians' business in this election.
What they're doing is completely 100% in the interests of Russia, which is to create as much damage and confusion to the U.S.
And it's working. The lies and false reports sending thousands into the streets for a pro-Trump protest this past weekend. And perhaps convincing millions of Americans to doubt the U.S. election system. Staunch Republican and former Trump National Security Advisor John Bolton says it's a damaging strategy that won't end after Trump leaves office.
Real distrust in the system, casting doubt on the integrity of our electoral system, the constitutional process. The Russians and the Chinese couldn't ask for any more. What Trump's doing is potentially dangerous for the country.
Allison, we've talked to former colleagues of Giuliani who question whether there's real cognitive decline leading to a lack of judgment. They just don't understand what has happened to Rudy Giuliani. One even noting that because Donald Trump doesn't even pay his attorney, Rudy is destroying his reputation.